go right ahead. Are there any changes or anything that anybody wants to add or subtract? If not, all in favor? Yes? Yes, thank you. We're lacking on public attendance. So we will move on to director's report.
Okay, so kind of a busy month. Another increase over, I mean, these are record number, this is record number territory every month, so that's exciting. We have some events coming up that we're excited about. We have, as you know, the Friends have decided on a model where they support our programming. We go to them with one big ask at the, beginning, was it December? I don't remember when it was. It was at the end of the year, I think, in the winter. And we just tell them what we want for the next year, what we're planning. And one of the things that we had talked about was an author talk or a community read. So we have a local author named Gretchen Grazina, whose book, Mr. and Mrs. Prince, which is not a new book, I think it's been out for a little while, but she's coming to talk about that. And it's about sort of the experience of some African American family who lived through the era of post, Civil War and what it was like to be in New England in those years. So that's going to be really exciting. So it's a Friends-sponsored event. We've got a collaborative, it's not really collaborative, we're more or less just letting them run free here, but the Hadley Historical Society, Alan Weinberg, has put together a program on historic samplers, the wine sewing project that a lot of women did back in the 19th and very early 20th century. So they have a bunch of examples of that, and they have an expert that's going to come and speak to that, Dr. Lynn Anderson. That's happening on Sunday, April 23rd in the afternoon. The other one, the previous book talk, is Wednesday, May 17th. We have a couple things that didn't make the director's report, but that I added afterwards to mention. We're finally having another compensation study done by an outside consultant. Well, someone that they've hired, I don't know, but we're going to have an introductory Zoom meeting tomorrow to find out how the process is going to go.
Is we, like the town employees or library employees? Or
the whole town. So the town undertook a similar study, I would say, about 5 years ago, and then promptly laid it aside and did nothing with it. And so we're doing it again. But in the meantime, the world has marched on with 8% inflation and everything else, and we have not been providing this sort of step increases that people expect to get when they are hired in a job, and that has caused some difficulty. Turnover. I mean, we've been lucky in that regard, but it's definitely a tension because it comes up in conversation, what's going on. And
I meant like in town, general. Okay. Yeah.
I mean, some of the other departments where you might expect that, like DPW, for instance, they have a union.
Yeah.
And the clerical folks that, and library staff would be included in that categorization, they're forming a union. That's a recent development, but it's going to be a while before they get to the point where everything is legal and then they will be able to negotiate with the town. But I think that it's safe to say that the reason that that is happening is because there has been neglect on the part of the town to address this, and people are kind of like, what other choice do we have other than to force the issue? So our folks will be a part of that, at least the staff that are benefited.
Good.
So that process is starting this week with the compensation study, so we'll find out what we need to do, what information we need to provide. We're having a meeting with Carolyn to discuss the status of the roof and to kind of get a path forward to get to solar. So we're going to be meeting with her next week. That's all I can say. So I,
Do you want to like summarize what, or do you want me to try to summarize what you and Lynn and I had talked about? You know, how we're sharing some
Let's
of the documents.
Let's wait until after we have a conversation with Charlie.
Yeah. I mean, there's really no update since the last time that we met, which, you know, I think I gave you the summary of what you learned from the roofers that, that we went out. In the meantime, I went back to the Board of Library Commissioners and asked them for, is that UPS coming to us? Anyway, I went back to the Board of Library Commissioners and said, do you have anyone that we could talk to that has experience in, you know, in evaluating designs and that kind of thing? And they didn't really have help, and they kind of said, you really should be going back through, you know, the whole OPM, and, you know, the town administrator's office should be taking an interest in this. Obviously they are, but we need to kind of get everybody facing in the same direction. So I don't really have anything new to report on that, other than that I'm in conversation with Carolyn and that we were going to meet next week and try to get an update, because it's been about 3 months since we met previously. And the only things that have happened really in the meantime have been us doing our own sort of independent investigation of, you know, what's actually happening up there. So we'll, you know, more at the next meeting about that.
And does anybody know what the situation with the senior centers bid was, because they went out to bid for the solar, right? That's 10%?
Yeah, and then something happened and I don't remember what it was. Something threw that off and I don't remember what the story was with that. Because I did hear that, and I think I did report that, but that's, you know, what was happening, and then something came up and I just can't recall what it was.
So it's not happening right now?
To my knowledge, I don't actually know, because it was probably 2 months that I heard that. They were going out to bid, then they weren't going out to bid, so maybe they're back out to bid.
Okay.
I really have no idea. I have, so last, this is just an odd housekeeping thing. Last meeting, I had asked for some help with Saturday's trustee coming in morning. He's going to come in on the 13th, so let in the friends of the
school. I can do the 6th, too.
You can do that, too?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Because I'll probably be here helping with the friends.
That'd be great.
Is that the top day? The 6th.
The guard?
Oh,
the sale. Yeah.
6 is a book sale. Yeah. Details to be determined. That's going to happen, actually. Great. Thank you. And then Lynn had asked me to take a look at the job description for my own position and see if it still correlates with the job. It mostly does. I didn't take anything out. I added a few things in and sent that around. They were mostly minor things, just half a dozen things. Mostly, I mean, I put in a mention of the friends, things like the capital campaign, which were not in there at all at the time. The last time that was revised was 2014 or before. That was the last approval date of that. So that was around when I was hired. So I don't know, does that need to be, is that something that needs to be approved? Or?
Well, this document, it says at the bottom, approved by Goodwood Memorial Library Trustees on July 22, 2014.
Well, that's the original.
Yeah, I should have crossed that out. Maybe that's,
but I think it was voted on by the trustees at that point.
But,
so,
but I revised it. I mean, I didn't revise it, but I, you know, I added it.
Right, so I'm saying, because it was originally voted on by trustees then, maybe it should be voted on by trustees now.
Oh, I see the point. Yeah. I agree. But is that, I mean, do we need to, I don't know if we need to do it now. Has everyone had a chance to even look at it?
I haven't.
Okay.
Well, I mean, we could use it as a first reading. Like, we could say today is a first reading to review next time.
Yeah.
But we review the policies.
Okay.
I did have a question on the capital. So, like, I noticed the things that you added, and while I don't disagree that you were doing that work, do we want to sort of saddle you with that into the future, especially if we don't really have currently an active capital campaign? Okay, just wanted to toss that out there as something that once it's in your job description, can be held accountable for it.
I would argue that even though there is not an active campaign going on, that I'm still responsible for it, because, you know, as you saw in the director's report, I received a gift from, you know, local donors this month, even though there was no ask, they just sent us money, and so I need to follow up with them. And, so it's still, when there's activity, I'm still the person that needs to keep their eye on it. And, you know, things like the donor wall, we're still, that's still down to me on a daily basis to make sure that there's progress on that. So, I mean, in the future, when it comes to the point where, you know, this needs to be revisited because we're like, oh, we're rehiring, what, does this make sense or not? Maybe that makes sense. But at this point, like, I'm the person that's doing it.
Okay.
If it comes out of there,
yep.
then, you know, who's
right.
doing it?
Would it be reasonable to frame it in more generic, managing any fundraising activity and gift receipt, rather than within the context of the capital campaign?
Well, for my part, just in terms of like what historically that has been part of the job that I've done, it may be a quiet part of the job right now, but it's been part of, it's been something, I would rather it to be more explicit in the job description based on the fact that, you know, it was something that I was asked to do and did it gladly. But in making it into just receipt of gifts makes it sound a little more
clerical
than it has been. And additionally, I think that, I mean, personally, I would hope that the trustees, at a point when they feel, you know, it recovered from the ordeal of getting through this project, that we revisit the capital campaign and it becomes, you know, continues to be an ongoing thing. So I hope that it's right now it's slow, but then we don't let all that progress die, because it was a lot of work that we put into it, and it shouldn't just get put into a file cabinet.
That's okay. That's.
And on that note, so I noticed that you said mid-May is when the donor wall is going to be.
Fingers crossed.
I know. So I would really like, and I'm happy to take charge of it, I don't know what it means, but to have some sort of event associated with it where anyone who has their name on the donor wall, or those people who have qualified, because remember, I'm like, been sitting on a small list, but these people donated. There's a lot of overlap between the people that would make the wall for the 2022 and the folks who are on the founders wall, but like invite them to, you know, just a reception, like a YNG's reception or something like that, and you know, maybe have some of the top donors speak or something, right? Like I don't know, but if is anybody in objection to this? I feel like I'm happy to take it on, but I don't want to infringe upon friends, so I thought maybe I could ask the friends, hey, you know, we're doing this, do you want it to be a thing? Right. I don't know what your guys' thoughts of, like, will the friends feel offended?
If
maybe it could be elaborate.
Well, that's what I don't know, like, do like, should I go to the friends and say, hey, this is my idea, do you want to do this jointly, or?
I think it certainly doesn't hurt to invite them, because, you know, they did give us a considerable amount of seed money to do that, and that should be recognized as well.
Well, it is. Yeah. Like, that would be obviously invited, the board.
But, I mean, do they even have a, did they get a book? Like, I'm trying to remember, did we?
I'm sure they must have.
I don't know if we did. Maybe we did. I'll have to go back and look at that.
It was so long ago since we put together that list.
Right. But by, you know, for the reason that you're stating, that the friends, like any other donor, have a part to play, should have to be given the opportunity to speak to, like, wow, what we did, this is what it means to be a friend, this is our role.
Yeah.
You know, so I think it would be good to raise that and see if they want to do something.
And they're meeting next week.
Yeah. The 18th.
Do I need to ask Sharon Kate on the agenda, or do I just show up? Well, I don't know how things are run.
It's kind of, it's free flowing.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm happy to.
I would be pleased if you were not only the liaison for the trustees, but perhaps the lead in organizing.
Yes, that's what I said. I wouldn't throw it out there and then stick someone else with it. So I would be happy to take the lead. I feel like it's a little too early to actually pick a date until we get a little bit.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, so the other thing, after I talk with the friends, right, they'll probably ask some questions, they'll probably want to know what the date is, right? I won't have the date, but I'll say if we're targeting mid-May, right? But then I think probably the next thing that would happen is for either you or me to get in touch with this guy and say, hey, can you give us a date that you can install something like, even if you can't promise you can be 100%, could you have the darn thing up by the end of May with whatever you got to date? And so that we can have, you know, a celebration on June 6th. I'm just making them a day.
I don't know how the fabrication will go because it is like a bunch of, you know, it is like laser cutting a bunch of sticks. So
yes.
I don't think he's probably like taking these and then doing wood varnish on each piece of wood. He's probably going to put it all together, assemble it, and then do finishing. So maybe that's possible, but I don't, I kind of sense that it's probably being done in a way that that might not be practical.
Okay.
Unless we were to ask him,
well,
point,
at some point, we
so
have
long.
To have a conversation.
Right, but I can't even remember at this point. It's been so long. And I don't. I feel like that sort of defeats the purpose because I think a big part of the event is going to be people, a big reason that someone would want to come in is to be able to come in and see their
yes.
mom's book.
Yes.
And if it's not
yes.
there, then they're like, well, call right. me when it is.
Yeah, well, I mean, it will be there, right? So I don't want to be in a situation where we're planning a celebration because it's going to take a lot, right? I assume we'd want to serve some wine
yeah.
or beer or whatever, which means we have a little bit of...
But I think we could do the whole planning just on paper and just be like, date to be determined. I mean, yes, getting someone, if you're going to have music play to get committed, you don't have a date, but I mean, you can still pretty much come up with like, okay, this is the format, this is what we're doing, here are the likely expenses, and then have the budget be ready to roll.
Yeah, that part I'm not worried about. It's more of the like actual logistics of like inviting people, getting people to come, getting a liquor license, etc.
Right. Yeah, I mean, I'll do my best. I've been, you know, pestering him and getting a date of mid-May seemed like a triumph.
I mean, the other thing is, like, you know, we can just pick a date. Like, I could just look on my calendar and say, what's the first Friday in June, right? And just say, hey, can you make a June 2nd deadline?
That makes it a lot more real for him.
Yeah.
To, you know, so, yeah, I mean, I think if we want to do that, we can try, but we may have to move it back.
Yeah.
Do you think it would help to have someone else call rather than each take turn?
Every week.
I have a good relationship with him. He's perfectly pleasant and you know good to deal with. It's just I get the sense that it's like a one man, pretty much like a one man business, and I think he's just overwhelmed.
Yeah.
And everything, you know, that seems like it should be easily delivered is.
Isn't.
Hey, I'm not judging how long he's taking.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to like see if
we can get a little bit
more clear.
If we want to come up with a date, maybe like
maybe mid June.
Raise this with the friends, see what the friends' reaction is, and if they say yeah, absolutely, we hear, you know, from them some things that maybe we need to work around with their own planning for events and what have you. Although I think they're pretty quiet in the summer. I don't think they do a lot in the summer.
Yeah, as of May.
Yeah, they usually take the
there's
summer.
Nothing during the summer.
But anyway, so let's have that conversation first and then pick a date, and I will get in touch with Dan.
Okay.
Ask him.
You think you can do this? Okay. So I put a note to myself to make sure there's no other town barriers to having it, like a June 2nd, like making sure that's not the graduation at Hopkins or whatever. You know, I'll just look up all the stuff in town that might be happening.
I think the first weekend in June
is it?
Yeah.
And it's not like asparagus festival or, you know, like all these things that start coming up. I'm just trying to not infringe upon those things.
I think that's a good thing.
It's the same weekend as
well, we can look into that.
And I can send Sharon an email requesting that you are on that.
Okay. Thank you.
Good time.
It would be good to just give her a heads up.
Yeah.
So I feel like that will be an opportunity. Like, we really haven't had an opportunity to celebrate in that way since the opening. And it's a good opportunity. We might get some additional donations. If nothing else, we can say, you know, thank you to all these people who, you know, had faith in this project all those years ago.
Right. And obviously, I mean, I think, you know, the capital campaign is still relevant. We still have expenses. We still have unknown costs. So I think it's actually a good time to, you know, remind people that we're here. And there's always going to be something that needs to be replaced, something that gets broken, something that, you know. Okay, great. HVAC, nothing.
We started talking about calling this a first reading of the job description, but do we need to do a vote on that?
No,
we don't need to vote.
We don't need to vote.
First reading, done, and we'll vote next month.
Yes.
Okay, all right.
I think that's really pretty much all that I've got.
Did you get a hold of that worker, Peter, or Gal?
I didn't, because really sort of...
Oh, you had it?
Yeah. The thought process started going in different directions, and at that point, you know, started to be in MDLC, and then, you know, it just seemed like maybe... One thing that the MDLC did mention that I thought was interesting was they suggested that there is a whole industry that goes under the title of, is it building science? Which is a whole, very holistic, you know, kind of look at building function and everything else. So they made that suggestion. But again, at that point, when I started thinking about, like, well, you know, now hiring another type of consultant that is unknown cost, maybe we just need to stop here and start questioning, like, what we're doing. And that's when I got in touch with Carolyn and said, let's sit down and figure out what the direction to go with this, because they have a part to play as far as this goes.
Yeah, for sure.
My underlying reason in asking Patrick to review his job description was twofold. First of all, his contract ends this year. And part two is, I think we owe it to Patrick, and it is our responsibility to conduct a review for a fiscal year, and doing so halfway into the next fiscal year is not optimal, and I would like to try to start planning that so that very soon after June 30th, we will be able to complete that. In a manner that is beneficial for everyone. If there are suggestions or comments from the board, then that gives Patrick time to work on them, and then it doesn't happen when we're in the crunch of putting other things together, and we will have that information for developing the budget and so on and so forth. And we had talked before about incorporating or providing staff with an opportunity to participate in providing feedback. And I don't have a magic solution to that to suggest, but I think that they have made it clear that they look at things in a very different way, and because of their small numbers, they would like to participate, but they would like to do so in a way that as much as possible doesn't necessarily identify individuals. And last year, Maureen and Jess worked on this, and I have not spoken to either about whether or not they would like to continue, but I'm just putting food for thought out there. If you all would give a little bit of thought to ways in which you think the process might be undertaken, what method we would use to solicit feedback from trustees and from staff, and coming up with a timeline for doing this closer to the end of the fiscal year than months afterward, because it gets to be a little bit, things sort of mesh together. Well, did that happen before June 30th, or did that happen after June 30th? And it's not helpful. Anyway, so I'm just asking people to think about the process and whether or not you would be interested in a more direct role in driving that. And I'm not. I am totally open to any suggestions. I do not have a preconceived notion, except to do it.
At a different time.
Yes. And maybe with changes to accommodate some issues that were identified last time around. So we will put that on the agenda for next time so that we can begin that process. I will send out an email like in 2 weeks to remind you to be thinking about this on your bike ride or your walk or while you're doing wrist exercises or whatever. And then if you have suggestions, I think it might be helpful if you would all send them to me and I will collate them and we can, in advance of the May meeting, that I can share that with everybody so we have a document, a starting point. Because it's a lot easier to edit than it is to try to create something cold. So that is my one request. I had every intention of watching the demo and I completely forgot about it.
I only got halfway through, but it's...
It's, yeah, it's pretty, you know, it's inside baseball, but I thought it was exciting because it, and really one of the big reasons that I brought it to your attention was because of that functionality for building a website, since that's an active discussion. And,
it could be a game changer.
And that everybody's would be similar, the same platform.
It's the same platform, there is expertise, they're talking about having expertise in-house, and CWRS is incredibly responsive, incredibly helpful, so this would be, a really great way to redesign the website and have, people that are going to pick up the phones, they're there 7 days a week, so I'm really excited about it, and I think it's going to save some money. I did send out an email to the director's listserv that I'm on and just said, hey, who's done a website lately? And this is actually before I found out about the Aspen thing. Mm-hmm. This actually came up in response to that. Someone from CWRS responded, but I got a bunch of responses that, covered the waterfront from, one guy at a small community library. He said, I was the guy in Barrie. And he said, I did it with...
my grandson. Over the weekend.
We had somebody that sort of says something like that, but it's not Squarespace. What's the thing with the website? I can't think of it, but it's like one of the ones that you use like templates and it's very intuitive and easy. So it was a learning curve. I figured out I did it for $400.
Yeah.
Great. And then we had somebody that said, like, if you're going to do this right, you're not going to spend less than $30,000. And I said, give me a break.
We're not going to do it right.
Yeah. We'll just slap something together over the weekend. Exactly. Get that guy's pants on.
That's not happening. So you can see there's just like this incredible disparity, and really what we're looking for is just a cleaner, more user-friendly, and easier to maintain website. So
well, something that's visually engaging as well.
Yeah. Well, that seemed like it was very user-friendly.
Well, it remains to be seen. It looks, the way that they're, it's a sales pitch.
Yes.
And that's really, you have to really use it yourself and make your own decision. But it looks good, and the fact that there's going to be support that we are already paying for, that when I say, the widget is broken, they're going to answer the phone and tell me how to fix it for me.
Correct.
And that's going to be a lot of value. So.
Yeah, it almost doesn't matter what it looks like, because whatever it looks like, it's going to be better than what we have now, and the fact that it's everyone's going to be the same or similar, and there's going to be support.
And there are so many people that have done this. This is, again, one of those things where it's like it's really not about reinventing the wheel. It's about finding something you like and, adopting that aesthetic or feel or functionality, and it should be a big deal. It's just a matter of, it really should be. A long weekend or a week's project, and then you get it done when you're like, all right, now it's just updating.
So CWRS has decided
The users council, which is like all of the member libraries, so everybody that pays their fees
right.
part of the network, they will vote in June whether to adopt this, because it will incur an additional cost
okay.
to members. And so it remains to be seen, but I really like that meeting, although yes, hopefully after that they'll start implementing it, because I cannot imagine that there is not a lot of enthusiasm, because the other stuff that was in that demo is really the kind of stuff that people have been asking, I mean, we've been asking for years and years. I mean, the software that we use for, the platform that we use for all our catalog is based on, and what the user sees, what we see on the back end, is open source, thing called Evergreen, that's mm-hmm. developed in the Georgia public libraries. It's been around for a long time, it's come a long way, and it's great in a lot of ways. It's, in a lot of ways, it's inflexible, it doesn't have, you know, the kinds of things where you like type in something incorrectly if it says, do you mean this, mm-hmm. or it gives you results anyway. It's like, the way it is now, it's like you typed in something wrong, and you just get no results, and you don't know why. So it overlays that, and then gives you like the sort of, I don't know if it's considered artificial intelligence or not, but it does, you know, the kind of like second guessing of like what the user is, you know, intending.
Yeah.
And then it pulls together a lot of what is here and now been very difficult for the user to see, where, you know, you've got, I go in to do a search on tigers for a fourth grade school report, and I get some books on tigers, and I'm like, but I'm not really seeing what I want. But now it's going to show you, you know, database results. You know, so you'll be able to look at, oh wow, I just want to look at database results, mm-hmm. or I'm going to look at all, you know, print results or ebook results, or it's all going to like push it together so that you can then go down this avenue or that avenue and find what you want, and maybe find a little of everything until you've got everything. But it's not easy to do that under the current catalog. It really is kind of like
you have to do another search.
Yeah. Yeah, and you have to know where those things are. You have to know where the databases are and sort of how to use them, because they're not very user friendly. So it's going to be a big improvement, I think.
Would it be the... Is it the case now that some libraries have access to databases that not everyone in CWMRS has?
If you pay for them all apart, you know, so for instance, we just paid, you know, I'm paying the bill this month for the consumer reports that we're subscribed to. So that is not a universal thing. That's, you know, there are libraries that have the resources to do that. Jones has a lot of, you know,
standalone
things that we don't have. But generally speaking, what is available within, you know, as paid members is the same from library to library.
So these add-on resources, would those show up for someone who is, would you have to enter your Hadley?
Do you think like the consumer reports thing?
Right.
Yeah, that's going to fall, I think that's going to fall outside of it, because that is,
okay.
that is just.
So within that will only be items,
yes.
resources that are shared by all?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. But it's going to make them all a lot more findable. There are certain prints. If there's access granted for certain subscriptions through CWMRS, then that will be there. I'm thinking of other things that, again, will probably not be there because they're sort of regional. Like we have Newsbank, which is a thing that allows you to access newspapers from Western Mass. I don't think that'll be part of it because not everybody has access to that. It's not consortium-wide.
The reason I'm asking is it's gonna require then some additional website information that says, in addition, please check these things.
Oh yeah, I mean exactly. We have a page now that lists databases. We'll still do that, even if, you know, you could reach that from the catalog. We'll still say if you just want to go to, you know, EBSCO or, you know,
right.
whatever database thing, here's how you go there directly and do that. Unless that changes, I don't see why it would. But yeah, we do have standalone things that we don't want to get lost in the mix of the pain. Yeah.
Do we have anything more on the Friends?
They've been pretty busy. Thursday, April 13th, we're going to have an author. Well, her name is, her name? Their name is Kelsey Schwab, Suspect Citizen. And that same night, they're going to have the Hadley Police.
Which day was that?
What is this? What day is
Thursday?
April 13th.
This week?
Yeah, I don't know if that's, I'm not sure if that's happening or not. I talked to Joanne, it's unclear, because we have, we've gotten no promotional stuff from the folks that brought that up. So it might be,
okay.
It might not be.
So April 18th is the next Friends meeting. Are they still doing, they're doing that in Tom Clark.
Yeah, everything else is the same, it's just that one.
Wednesday, April 26th at 6 p.m., Gardening with Perennials. Tom Clark is going to be the guest speaker. He is the head harbor, head gardener at Mount Holyoke.
Yeah, he's got a fancy title.
Yeah.
I don't remember what it was.
Like probably head of the botanical garden.
So, yeah.
And then May 6th is the book sale. May 13th is a possible event with Cheryl Wilson.
It's not, I think that one is finalized. I don't think it's possible. I think it's happening.
Oh, good.
Actually,
okay.
It might have a flyer.
So that's at
Saturday, May 13th. Will be, yeah, Cheryl Wilson.
And she wrote a book called Valley Gardens that she's going to have, and she'll find books.
She was the gardening columnist for the
Gazette.
Or the Gazette.
Yeah.
Or which one was it? Was it both?
Well, it ran both.
Yeah, Daily Hampshire Gazette for 30 years. So she, I think the book is like a compendium of like columns that she wrote when she was in that position.
The April 1st, the new, or the spring newsletter came out.
It did?
I didn't see it. Did they email it? Or?
I didn't contribute anything for it because no one asked me. I wasn't given a deadline, so maybe or maybe not.
Maybe, yeah. And let's see, their focus is recruiting.
Okay. I didn't know. Usually I would get those.
Yeah.
Usually you do get them?
Yeah, I think
yeah,
I do.
Yeah.
I feel like
it,
I get
I think
them.
It might not have gone out, but.
Do we have anything else?
I just want to suggest that on the agenda next month, we can bring back the project of
sort of
the survey. Yeah.
And do we know?
And is our next meeting after the election?
I was going to ask, do we know, do we have two candidates?
Yes.
We do.
I think so. John Pellick.
Yeah, no, I didn't know. John, remember we were all giving him excited advice about how to get those papers done in like 3 days?
Yeah.
I didn't know.
He did.
Okay, that's great.
I think the names were listed in the newspaper.
Joanne.
Okay,
I just, yeah. Maybe Joanne Scott or something.
I think.
I missed it.
My neighbor's taking my newspapers.
Mm. Well, that's it.
Well, she gets the newspaper for also putting my mail in the garage. So. Well, okay. Anything else? Then I'd be happy to entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Ooh, a record setting. 41 minutes. Yes.
Now really is the shortest meeting.
I know.